Oh, yeah.
Bob Bowden's educational documentary focuses on America's failing public school systems, its problems including cultural bias against voucher systems, school tenure, corruption, teacher unions, as well as lack of choice in the school systems themselves. Now, it's really fascinating how in-depth this documentary really goes into the issue. This guy focuses mostly on New Jersey, but he points out some of the national problems that this country has. We spend more money on education than pretty much any other country per student. However, our education, our test scores for our kids are lower than a lot of these developing countries. So it's really fascinating. For example, in New Jersey, he points out that there's a big union push against school vouchers, because school vouchers are essentially scholarships. He interviews people on the streets, a lot of blacks, working class people, and he notices that there's a strong bias against school vouchers, but a lot of people don't really understand what they really are. It's almost as if a lot of these so-called leaders in these communities, the poor black communities, or what, and a lot of poor communities in general, are using illogical arguments to get people to support, to go against something that's essentially in their best interest. Now, the documentarian argues that with choice comes a better school systems for the public system. A lot of people argue that school vouchers are a bad idea because even though it allows some kids, a lot of kids to go to a better private schools or charter schools with these scholarships, it leaves a lot of kids behind. In these public schools, and they suffer. But as a doc, as Bob points out, when this happens, a lot of the kids excel at the charter schools, and the kids who are left at the actual public schools are actually better off because there's more resources available to them. It's really interesting. He highlights how there's a strong push. There's a lot of people who really want to send their kids to charter schools, and one of the reasons why they want to do it is because of safety. It's fascinating how he destroys this whole pseudo-partisan argument. People argue that, well, you know, this is a Republican agenda, but he interviews teachers, he interviews Democrats, he interviews people who supported Obama, and they support the voucher system, because the voucher system essentially gives people a choice. You don't have to be stuck in a lousy school. You can send your kid to another school, and by having that type of competition, as Bob argues, this increases the quality of all schools, because it forces the schools to get better, because in the systems that they have in New Jersey right now, or when they had it, even if a public school wasn't very good, they still received more money. So money obviously wasn't a problem. 90% of the money actually went to non-teachers. 90% of the money didn't even go to teachers. They had janitors with six-figure salaries. They had administrators who would get a $700,000 severance pay. One person was fired and got over $400,000. The administrator with the severance pay of $700,000, he actually received a pension of over $100,000 a year. It's really unbelievable when you actually look at what's happening. The corruption is another element that this documentary focuses on. Five school board members in the Pleasantville school district were indicted for accepting bribes, which is incredible. And a lot of people argue that, well, it's not enough money going to these poor schools. At Malcolm X Chabez High School, they actually had $30 million into a football field. They spent $30 million for a state-of-the-art football field, and only one out of seven of their high school seniors were proficient in math when it came to the state test scores. That's incredible. You're spending $30 million on a field, and you can't even... almost none of your kids are even proficient in math, your seniors. I mean, it's incredible. It's absolutely insane. Another element, he talks about how teachers try to speak out against the corrupt system. There was actually money mismanagement in the system, money going to positions where people didn't even fill them. Teachers trying to speak out, administrators, people trying to speak out, and whenever someone speaks out, they get punished. One lady was demoted, and the entire district knew all about it. Teachers are afraid to speak out, as one teacher pointed out, because they're afraid that, you know, they're going to lose their job, they're going to be punished, they have kids to support, they have their own expenses. So the name of this documentary, The Cartel, is a really interesting title. I don't know if it's really that fitting. I understand where it came from with The Cartel, but the title itself a lot of people may not even understand what the documentary is about, and that's one of the things you want to do with a documentary. You want to have a title that it does grab people's attention, but it has to explain sort of what the movie is actually about. So that's one of my critiques about the film. Security becomes a major issue. There's one incredible scene where they have an auction for the charters. A lot of people argue that, well, the charter schools do better because the better kids go to the charter schools. Turns out it wasn't really true in New Jersey. They actually have an auction, and people are just randomly selected. And they find out that these kids who are randomly selected, their test scores are pretty much better than the state schools. But although there are some state schools, there are some charter schools that don't have higher test scores, but again, they focus on security. A lot of parents are still happy because at least their kids are safer. Don't have to worry about the fights and the gangs and the violence and all that. It's a big topic to take on. But going back to that scene I was talking about, you had this auction, and you know they have a lot of black parents there, obviously from poor areas. And when they start naming the names, this one woman, she's just overjoyed. She's like, "Thank you, Jesus," and all this. She's crying, and people hugging. But then you can see this one little girl just sitting down. Her name isn't called. She's just crying. She's on the waiting list. She's just crying. It's just, this is really good. This is really good. Check this out, guys. It's called The Cartel, and it's about education. It's truly remarkable. So overall, yeah, we spend more money on education than a lot of countries. But the big part of the problem is that so much of the money goes to the administration. For example, when you compare New Jersey to Maryland, Maryland, I think, only has about 24 school districts, and New Jersey has over 616. And the more school districts you have, the more administration you have, which means more cost. You have more money for the secretaries for each position, the curriculum advisor or whatever, administrator, whatever. You have assistants below that. So most of the money isn't really going to the kids. And when you look at these charter schools, it's quite interesting. They actually spend less money per kids, but the test scores are usually higher. So it's really fascinating. This is definitely worth watching. You can find this on Netflix Instant, all right? The Cartel. It comes highly recommended. All right, guys, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.